Beautiful nature. I love this.
Yeah, but it's a hot Senora, isn't it?
Because you're only 20. I feel more tired today than usual. Go. If you wish to check with your guard.
He's not mine. He belongs to the park.
He belongs to you more than the park. Anyway, go. Find him. Hey! Not more than 10 minutes, okay?
Yes, Senora.
Hey, Pedro! Come back! Get me the cereal.
I don't know what's the matter with me.
I do. Your mind is where your heart is. With the guard. Oh! That big one! Over there! It's always fast. Oh! This one is the least timid. I know. You would eat from my hand. Look at that. Philosopher. Okay. Stop here all. I'll bring more tomorrow.
You can sit here, Senat. There is only a lady.
I want a bench for myself, Janito.
But there is none, Senar.
That one over there, it's mine. Rout them out.
Sir?
Oh, no hope of their living. Come this way, Janito.
Hey, you! Look up! You've scared away the birds.
Are you speaking to me, Senora?
You have scared away the birds who were feeding on my cereals.
Why should I care about the birds?
But I do!
This is a public park, you know.
Then why do you complain that the priest have taken your bench?
Senora, we have not met. I cannot imagine why you take the liberty of addressing me. Come, Janito.
Why must people get so fussy and cross when they reach a certain age? I'm glad he knows the bench. Find a seat if you can, poor man.
Have the priest gone yet, Janito?
No, Senar. They are still talking.
Oh, the authorities here should have placed some more benches for this sunny morning. Well, I suppose I must resign myself and sit on the bench with that old lady. Good morning.
What? You're here again?
I repeat, we have not met, Senora.
I was responding to your salute.
Good morning, Sylvia answered by good morning.
You should have asked permission to sit on this bench, which is mine.
The benches here are public property, you know.
Why? You said the one priest have was yours?
Very well. I have nothing more to say. Tough lady.
Yes, I am for the kinds of you.
Do you use your handkerchief as a shoe brush?
Why not?
Do you use your shoe brush as a handkerchief?
It's none of your business, Senora.
It's a neighbor's right.
Don't criticize my accent. I do not care to listen to nonsense. Janito, my book.
You're very polite.
Pardon me, Senora. But don't interfere with what doesn't concern you.
I thought you were taking out a telescope.
Oh, was that you?
Your sight must be sharp.
Oh, sharper than yours is. Ask Harrison Petridges.
Oh, you hunt?
Yes, I did. Even now.
Of course.
Yes, Senora. Every Sunday, I take my gun and dog. You understand? And go to one of my estates near Aravaca and kill time.
Oh, kill time? That is all you kill?
Do you think so? I could show you wild boar's head in my study room.
Oh, and I could show you a tiger skin in my private room. What does it prove?
Will you have some?
If it is good.
It is one of the finest. You will like it.
Read as loud as you please. You will not disturb me.
All love is sad, but sad as it is. It is the best thing that we know. It is from Campomore. Can you read without any?
20 years pass. He returns. Can it be that this is he? Heavens, is it she?
Indeed, I envy your wonderful eyesight.
Word by heart.
I am very fond of good verses. Very fond. I even composed some in my youth.
Any good ones?
I was a great friend of Campomore, Zoria Becure. I first met Zoria in America.
Have you been in America?
Yes, several times. The first time I went, I was only 6 years old.
You must have gone with Columbus in one of his caravels.
Not quite as bad as that. I'm old, I admit. I didn't know Ferdinand and Isabella, but I was also a great friend of Campomore. I first met him in Valencia. I'm a native of that city, you know.
Are you?
Yes, I was brought up there and spent my early youth. Have you ever visited that city, Senora?
Yes, Senor. Not far from Valencia, there was a villa that, if still there, should retain memories of me.
I spent several seasons there. It was many years ago, near the sea, hidden away among the lemon and orange trees. They called it Maricela.
What? Maricela?
Maricela? Is the name familiar to you?
Yes, very familiar. If my memory serves me right, for we forget as we grow old. There lived in that villa the most beautiful woman I have ever seen. I assure you, I have seen many. But she is... let me see, what's her name? Laura... Laura Lawrence!
Laura Lawrence? She reminded me of my best friend.
How strange!
It is strange. She was called the Silver Maiden.
I object, lady. It's not strange she was called the Silver Maiden. Locality can't help. What color so? I seem to see her as if she was before me now, at that window with the red roses.
Senor?
She was ideal. Fair as lily. Jet black hairs and black eyes. with uncommonly sweet expressions. She seemed to cast radiance wherever she was. Her figure was beautiful, perfect. What forms of sovereign beauty God models in human clay. She was a dream.
She was very unfortunate and had a sad love affair.
Very sad.
Did you hear any of it?
Yes, of course. The gallant lover was my cousin, of whom I was very fond.
Oh yes, a cousin. My friend told me one of a little of that affair, which was truly romantic.
Your cousin passed by on horseback every morning, down the rose path under her window.
And later in the afternoon, the gallant horseman will return by the same path and catch the bouquet flowers which will toss him. Am I right?
Listen, or?
Long back in 19th century.
Why are you late, Don?
I wanted these ladies to meet you as they were climbing something, which I know it's not true.
What ladies? Where are they? What are they claiming? What's not true, Don?
Hey, Don, tell me, I'm curious. Are you being poetic?
Don, where are the ladies?
In your hand, my lady.
Oh, are they? What did they claim?
The garden, they were shouting and claiming that they are the most beautiful in the world.
Oh, they're right, Don. Aren't they? What's not true in that?
No, Dad, I know someone more beautiful, so I bought them.
Don't be kidding. Who is more beautiful than them?
You, Lara, you!
But her family wanted her to marry to a rich merchant, against her will.
Yes, yes, against her will. My cousin saw merchant and silver Manon happily talking on the dream window. He consoled his jealousy by his love for her. But he was heartbroken when the servant told that they are getting married.
And you think Laura insulted your cousin?
Yes, she did cheat on him. There was a quarrel between my cousin and merchant on the beach, and the merchant was badly wounded. Fearing the consequences of duel with a person highly regarded in that locality.
Your cousin misunderstood the whole situation, Senor. She waited for him. She never married a merchant.
What? Oh, she seems completely innocent.
And was it you by any chance?
Why? It's not me. It's my cousin, I told you.
No, I was asking, was it you by any chance who advised to your cousin to forget Laura?
Why? My cousin never forgets Laura.
Do you account then for his conduct?
After all, he went to Sevilla and came back to Madrid. He wrote Laura many letters, but they were intercepted by their parents. She never answered at all, in believing his love lost to him forever. Joined army and went to Africa. And there in a war, met a glorious death, grasping the flag of Spain and whispering the name of his beloved, Laura, Laura.
It's really sad.
For my cousin, yes. But your friend spent time chasing butterflies in the beautiful garden.
No, Senor, no.
It is a woman's way.
Yes, it is a woman's way. The silver maiden awaited news for days, months, a year, and no letter came. One afternoon, just at sunset, when the first stars were appearing, she was seen to leave the house with the quickening steps, went her way forward to the beach. The beach where her beloved had missed his life. She wrote his name on the sand and then sat down upon the rock, her gaze fixed upon the horizon. The tide rose with a boom and swept her out to sea.
Oh God, this is sad.
The fisherman told me the story, which he says with his helpless, tearful eyes, that he could not save Silver Maiden.
Stories of life are strange. Truth hides from eyes. They should have tried seeing reality with their heart.
Poor Gonzalo.
Poor Laura.
Fate is curious. Here, you and I, completely strangers, met by chance, discussing the romance of old friends of long ago.
We have been conversing as if we were old friends.
What a moment life will bring, Senora. I'm just speechless.
Yes, it is curious, considering the ill-natured prelude to our conversation.
I am too sadly changed. It is better you should remember me as a black-eyed girl tossing flowers at him.
No, no. I'll not reveal myself. I'm old now. Better she recalls the gallant horseman who passed daily beneath her window, tossing flowers. Egypt, Egypt. I missed a pure soul and love.
Senor, are you coming tomorrow?
If it's a sunny morning, yes. Will you object if I come to this bench, Senora?
Senor, benches here are public property. Are you going to scare the birds again?
No. Next time I'll bring cereals myself.
Let's take a walk. I know a beautiful place nearby.
Okay, Senor.
If Silver Maiden leave, she could be like you, I think.
She made me blush at this age.
You could be a close competition to her, Senora. Where did you hide yourself? Among the lemons and orange trees.
The guard gave me this flask for you, Senora.
You are late, Janito.
Wow, it's nice.
My dear lady, this has been a great honor.
Same here.
Goodbye until tomorrow.
Till tomorrow?
If it's a sunny morning, tomorrow.
Let me pick it for you, sir.
Picking these flowers is my job. Heavens, it is he.
Can it be that? This is he? It's him. I know from the gut.
Who? Who is he, madam?
It's him, Petra.
Who? Who? Don Gonzalo.
Wow, I cannot believe it. Wow, madam, you guys confessed each other.
How does it gone, madam? Wow, you must have told him. He told he'll come tomorrow, right?
Tell me, madam, I'm curious about the love story that waited this long.
How did he react, madam? What did he tell? He must have...
Oh, hold on. You seem to be more excited than me. I didn't tell him. It's me, the Silver Maiden. I did, but I lied. It's my cousin.
Why, madam? You told him he was your love. You waited for him, right? You were ready to be with him. Then...
I told him. My cousin waited for him. And then she lost her life. In his memory.
And I married 2 years later. Here I am now.
Why did you lie to him, madam?
I don't know. Maybe I thought I should have waited for him. But I forgot his way. And got a long life.
Do you regret that?
Moments ago, yes. But not now. We decided before discovering ourselves. Most importantly, we didn't discover our own desires.
What's our own desires, Senora?
It is this thing, Petra.
We need someone to validate our existence, beauty, which we should be doing ourselves. We must fall in love with ourselves. Love is something we share. To share, we must have it first.
You mean you didn't know each other, so you took the other road?
Yes, we had affection for looks, which blinds us in our youth. Youth fades, character grows and stays.
Madam, you're saying falling in love means to commit to a character than beauty? Is true friendship only the way to love? We love by being vulnerable and exposing our honest feelings
and not by hiding whom we truly are? Yes, Petra. Beauty is just skin deep. Love is much deeper than that. Excuse me, Madam.
I'm not her daughter. I'm not rich. I'm her maid.
It's her. It's her. I'm sure it's her.
Sir, I've never seen you so excited with your words.
Who is she? It seems you share a story with her.
Yeah, Janito. I do share a story of my infant romance. A crazy, stupid, and glorious days with her.
Senor, I'm sure she's Lara. Where's this bride? when you told me of you and her.
Yes, she is. Yes, I am.
Finally, you found your love, right, sir?
No, Janito. It never was love. We both took mass and discussed our own stories as someone's.
Is that the reason behind?
Though all love is sad as it is.
No, Janito. Not all love is sad. If we love someone unconditionally, we'll let other people shine. We'll let them be their most impressive, inspiring, happy, contented versions of themselves. We also let them be sad, depressed, or angry. But we don't force or manipulate them into something we think they should represent. They have full freedom to decide how to feel and how to behave. We take them as they are. We love all their beings,
all their energies.
We love their soul.
No single bad character trait or behavior can fool us.
Because we see their soul and we love them as they are.
Then why can't people love like this?
That my directors will tell you.
Anyone who wants to find the greatest love of their life, listen to this greatest secret. My dear warriors, greatest wars in coming times will not occur on the battlegrounds with the weapons, but in our own minds. Oh my young warriors, win this war of good versus evil, your best thoughts versus worst of your thoughts. Become a person you can fall in love with. Become a person you can respect. Give this world a chance to love you. Work hard on your dreams. Greatest love will find you. Be a gift to this world, warriors. Be a gift.